Hello fellas, I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to rock and roll with a convoy. I hope you are having a bloodyful day, and our plan is going to be to make this vehicle work. I don't really like this tank, I must admit it, it's not my favorite vehicle, but in the end of the day you are going to get awarded if you are grinding this line with a trash bird which can send a lot of people to the garage, so probably in the end it's worth it. So it is looking very, very interesting, fellas. Charioteer as a tier 8, it's epic. Challenger is fine. F-Hill is very, very fine. Convoy is the biggest poop out of those tanks, at least for me. Once again, majority of you might say skill, you are talking Kaku, but the thing is, it is only my opinion. And if you are enjoying this vehicle, good, great for you. I cannot say the same thing, right? Anyways, there is two guns on this vehicle. Let's start everything with a derp gun. The derp gun is the alpha damage of this vehicle. Plus on top of that, this tank have very, very spicy gold ammunition, which have lower amount of damage. Lower amount of penetration, but bigger amount of damage which this vehicle can make. So it's very, very interesting stuff. Instead of talking too much, I believe we can go into the battlefield and I can talk more about this vehicle. So what exactly I don't like? I don't really feel like I can be super aggressive with this vehicle. For some reason, I just don't find a way to make this armor work. This is the number one thing. Number two thing, this vehicle do not have any camo whatsoever. Number three thing, speaking about the shell velocity with a big gun, it's no bueno and it's very, very, very bad, at least for me, and this is only my opinion, right? Speaking about the gun, other gun now, it has nice DPM, very nice DPM, but once again, I am struggling to play with this vehicle. And yes, I know I'm reading comment section, I am reading comments. Skill, you're saying you're struggling, but you have third mark. Third mark of excellence, fellas, is one thing, and other thing is how you are feeling the tank, right? And when I'm feeling the tank, I'm saying, oh, I feel that tank, I am feeling epic, and I love the style of the vehicle, I love the things about the tank. When I do not feel the things I'm saying, I simply don't feel the love for vehicle, you know? And it's very, very important thing for me, fellas, to feel the love for a tank. This is going to be epic. Now. Ay, ay, ay. Nice, that was beautiful. So we loaded high explosives and we managed to penetrate him with a 200 millimeters of penetration straight in the face. You can say whatever you want, that was beautiful, okay? That was beautiful, fellas. So I'm very, very happy with the shot. Let's see, can we get some more use out of this? That would be very, very good. So first things first, I'm going to come to this position over there and I am simply waiting until the enemies are going to make something bad, right? Maybe their 3090 is going to peek like this, you never know. Patience is the key right there, fellas, so let's be patient. Also, there is a big chance they have some bushwhackers over there in the back, but you know. How to hit them? Let's go with a blind shot. Definitely not a hit, but worth a try anyways, and I'm getting spotted, so immediately I'm running away. Now the main difference between this tank and Fava is the vehicle itself. This tank have better backward speed, which is very, very helpful, and in fact it's very, very good. Budget, mine. Nothing happened. Okay, I planned this. I actually planned this, boys and girls. Cheek. And this is not a penetration in the cheek, okay? It's about the time to say goodbye. Since they have quite fat lemming train, which is going like this, I just want to run for my life before it's too late. Now, one more thing which I really want to highlight about this vehicle, especially when you are using the derp gun. So what is happening? You do not have the full turret rotation. It's very, very important thing to mention. So it can be tricky to play with this vehicle, right? So no full Tourette rotation. It's only 180 degrees into the sides, right? So the other gun, if I'm not mistaken, since I haven't played with this tank in a while, other tank have way. With other gun you can rotate your turret fully. And this is very important information, and I just must say that to you, my lovely friends. I just must say that. And now once again, we are shooting the high explosives right here, and the main reason why we are doing this golden high explosives, by the way. And the main reason why am I doing this, I simply feel like I can penetrate some vehicles right here, and it's doing more damage, right? So, more damage is always, or usually, better, right? Now this tank. Boop. Unfortunately, that was not the case, and the budget Arta managed to hit me right there, which was actually very, very unfortunate, but once again, I cannot change it, right? So patience, patience, patience. We are waiting for another couple of seconds until we can hit this guy sideways, right? And waiting, 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 incoming. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. This is the hit which I really wanted to hit, right? Beautiful. Obviously, our team is melting and enemy team are playing actually very, very well, so I can't complain about this. Anyways, aiming for a side, another 700 for the team. You know, it's interesting. It's definitely interesting vehicle with this derp gun. Is it mine? Well, this is the other question. It is the other question, and obviously 200 in the side. It's okay. No complaints, no regrets. I hope this T-57 is going to die very, very soon. That's what I am hoping for, and T-57 should be dead now. Beautiful. And obviously, scale you gold noob. Call me dirty, fellas. Call me dirty. Let's run away. Which position do I want to take? I want to take this position over there, so maybe we can have an angle to that progetto. Although, I must admit, I could go like this and I could kill Bacchet Arta. So maybe I should do that. Decisions, decisions. We can definitely push this Arta, push this battle a bit better. Look at into the flat side, aiming, 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 Russia. Another not penetration. Well, that sucks. Anyways, you can see this vehicle can work, and in a way it is not working. Speaking about the golden ammunition itself. But you can have a very, very, very good time with it. Let's put that in this way. Anyways, what we are trying to do right here, we are trying to build a better angle for Mr. Jack Pizda, which is playing over there, and we have the angle right here, but Jack Pizda is already pushing in front. Our guys is getting banged over there, and in fact, they are dead already. So what do we want to do? We want to find the enemy Arta, and we want to simply eliminate him from the game. Where exactly enemy Bacchet is sitting at? In my opinion, Bacchet clicker should be around this area. But once again, it's only prediction, it's only the guess, fellas. Anyways, let's go. Easy, fellas, easy. I mean, let's get real, we are not going to win this battle, but what we can do, we can get more use. By the way, DPM with high explosive rounds with this vehicle is actually very, very, very good. And this is definitely the thing which needs to be highlighted. If you are penetrating, I think it's going to be just epic. Compared to the other 750 alpha damage guns. We did not manage to find the budget clicker, but hey, it is how it is. How about if we will try to build the angle for Mr. Jack Pizda, which should be around this area already? Or should I just go for Artas and just to eliminate them from the game and feel better inside? And after this, we are going to load the high explosive golden round. And the main reason for that, why we are going to do this, because the next tank which we are going to meet more likely is not going to have too much armor whatsoever, right? So this is my goal. This is my dream. By the way, those guys, more likely they were searching for me over there. So they should already try to make a pressure like this. So I need to go in... in this position like this. Can we still win? Absolutely not. But we can try to get as much use as we can. Okay, good. We are sitting in the top bush right here, and the first victim which we should be able to spot more likely is going to be either TVP, either Progetto, coming from this way. I thought I missed that completely. My aim was pretty horrible. Not gonna lie, fellas. My aim was pretty horrible. It's okay. No complaints, no regrets. Let's return into the same position over there. And Progetto should be very, very, very close. T-54. Fellas. Holy bananas from banana land. You know what we are going to do? Because I'm not a pussy. We are going to get killed by Jack Pizda. It's okay. It's understandable. So what happened right here? I shouldn't get closer here to get proxy spotted. And I must admit those artists relocated. They had a keyboard, which is impressive. It's not happening every single day. I think both of the clickers moved at least 1 kilometer. Let's check it out. I'm very, very curious. Anyways, 3,600 damage in this certain situation. That was okay battle. Obviously, I could get probably more use if I would shoot the standard rounds, but I was feeling like I want to derp around. Speaking about the Artas, one of the clickers moved 2 kilometers, another clicker moved 1.4 kilometers, and he have a bomber for himself. Very, very rare medal to get. Either way, we did as much as we could do. Should I go another round with this gun? Absolutely yes, kill, do it! Derp guns can be... You know, derp guns are very, very interesting. Sometimes it can be a blast to play with, and sometimes it can be, you know, damn it. If I would have the other gun, I could get more use. Comparing, the best example of all this is the T49. T49 with a derp gun, and T49 with a standard gun. Convoy. Or however you are calling this vehicle, with a derp gun and with a standard gun, you know, there is a difference in my opinion in those vehicles. And either you can pretty much have the same name, Convoy, but there is two possibilities how you can play. Same for a T49, but two possibilities how to play with a vehicle, right? Interesting stuff. Anyways, what we are going to do right here, we are not going to play in the city, although I know I could, but I don't. Maybe I should. Yeah, I have a feeling the main battle is going to be over there. So what we are going to do, we are going to piri piri over there. This is my decision. Also, I want to have the high explosive first. Because there is a chance enemies will try to cross like this, and I really want to punish someone which is doing so. So let's do this. And one of the most important things, if not the most important thing, fellas, you grinding through this vehicle, you played with this tank. What is your opinion about the convoy? Do you think it's good? Do you think it's bad? It's a very, very important question. So people which... is planning to grind this vehicle for themselves, they will know what is more people opinion, not only me, if you know what I mean. Okay, the chieftain is crossing like this, not a big deal, everything is fine, let's keep going like this, piri 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 piri, just like this, fellas. And we are about to enter into position which I want to be in. Very good. So the first things first, if Progetto is going to peek like this, we will try to punish him for his stupidity, right? If he is going to peek. By the way, there is a Škoda which is going vroom 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 through the middle of the field and boom. Oh, bummer. We did not manage to penetrate the Škoda side, which is very, very unfortunate in my opinion, because that could be a tasty penetration. But you know what? I have a feeling we can go for another one right here, right? How about if I will be more greedy? And I will go like this. Lower plate shot, 700 damage. This guy took one for the team. Now the next thing what we are going to do, we are going to shoot this chieftain ass over there. Are you ready for this? High explosive in the butt and then run. I am running already because he is going to have... Ooh, he's going to have troubles. Now we are running. Because he is focusing on us and I simply need to escape from here. We escaped, very, very good. And now we are going to try to punish the samurai, which might push in front like this. That would be very, very, very good. By the way, this chieftain is having such a horrible time right there. Good. As you can see, the derp gun can actually work. I am actually happy with the current performance. I mean, despite the fact, currently when I am recording the video, it's very, very late night, and I need to pre-make videos because it's making my life 10 times easier, but in the same time, I want to play the game, you know? So yeah. Okay, patience, 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 patience. Samoa down to the 400 hit points. What can we do? I could load the standard ammunition right here. Do I want to? This is the other question. Do I want to? This is the other question, boys. Wait for it, wait for it. Wait for it, wait for it. Patience, 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 patience. This Ruski light will try to do something right there. Bad reaction time, but we managed to punish him anyways. Beautiful. Fellas, we are getting there. Oh, we are working our way to the Olymp of the Damage. Good. Okay, how about if we will try to blind fire this Progetto? Why to blind fire when we can kill him? Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. Now. That was perfect frame. Too bad I did not manage to hit him. And 6 seconds left. 4 seconds left. 3 seconds left. 2 seconds left. You see, the derp gun can work very, very well, but in the same time, the derp gun can be the gun which is actually mixing the cards, if I can say so. Which is not so fun and not so good, in a way. It's okay, 3,500 already. I'm very, very happy with this battle. But you know what? The most enjoyment I am getting with this tank is to shooting the derp gun, at least. And with the derp gun, I actually kind of like it. At least this is today's opinion. Overall, I remember I had some kind of hate for this vehicle, or I said, this tank. Now it is completely fine and I am feeling like a fresh pickle while playing with it. Patience. If Samoa will go in front, we can hit him. If the convoy will go in front over there, we will hit him. There is a big fat chance we are actually winning this battle and that things are going very, very well for us. I mean, I could try to make a pressure on this guy over there, but it would be a bit more complicated. Samoa, Russian, good. This guy is dead. Excellent. Very, very good. My reaction time is definitely not there. I believe you noticed that when I pretty much did not react twice to the Ruski light tank, and it's just proving the things. But it's completely fine. Not the first time, not the last time. Now we are getting closer to the Ruski light over there, and obviously he's trying to run for his life. He took one for the team right there from our ally, but it's okay. We are waiting, 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 and there is a big chance he is going to appear here in a second, so be patient and wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. What is the chance we can kill Progetto, which is sitting right there somewhere? There is only one way to figure this out. By killing him. Very good. Okay, so what is our plan right here? We want to make a hardcore pressure on this Ruski light. I'm not entirely sure this Ruski light is sitting next to this building or not, but there is only one way how we can figure this out. We are going super aggressively, and the answer is Ruski light is not over there. Interesting. Meanwhile, our clicker blind shotted the Udes tank destroyer, which is very, very excellent blind shot from our team, and that's it. Finito. Beautiful, fellas. I am happy with this performance. I don't really think we have any blind shots, but I am feeling either way, I'm feeling very, very Gucci with this performance and with this battle, right? I think we did everything properly, apart couple of the bad reaction shots, if I can say so. Anyways, should I load the AP? Should I or should I yell Russia and try to hit this M53 on the move? That would be excellent, but obviously it's not going to be the case. Okay, so what we are going to do, I am trying to repush like this because apparently this Ruski light is going for our artists. So maybe there is a tiny chance the Ruski light is going to kill the clickers, right? This is the plan. Let's see. I am happy with this tank performance. I was thinking it's shitter tank than it is with a derp gun. And obviously I'm derping with a high explosive gun right here, but I am enjoying myself. And this is not that many tank destroyers with which I could say the same thing, okay? By the way, have you ever heard the lights are killing Artas? The legend of the world of tanks. Light tanks cannot play Artas. Not today, buddy. Not today. Okay, I'm happy with this performance. I am. Now it is about the time to change the gun and try to play with the DPM gun. Let's see, can we craft enough use for ourselves? So what we have right here, we have solid 3,900 damage with which I am very, very, very happy with. I am very happy with this performance. Okay, let's change the gun. And speaking about the standard gun, now we should have fully rotatable turret, which is definitely very important part to say. We have a nice high explosive penetration, 120, which is actually very, very good for the 400 alpha damage tank, right? To have 120 penetration, it's called HESH, right? Well, it's even saying there, HESH. The gold penetration is 326, which is nice, and the standard penetration is 259, which is completely fine. I mean, there is some tier 10 heavy tanks which don't have this penetration. Let's go into the battle and let's check it out what this tank is all about. Maybe I was using the wrong gun, although I remember when I was marking it, this tank, I don't really think this vehicle had a choice. I think this tank always had 400 alpha damage gun, but maybe it is only my imagination, I don't know. Ooh, look into this matchmaking. So what do we have right here? Speaking about matchmaking, we are having the tier 7 game, so we are actually going and playing aggressively with this tank destroyer because we have a turret. Although the armor is not the armor with which we can trust, but it can bounce shot or two, especially the turret. If I'm not mistaken, it's over 200 millimeters thickness over there, if I'm not mistaken, right? Now the first thing which I really want to show for you, my lovely friends, is the full rotation of the turret, right? So let's see, is it the case or am I lying? And the answer, you see, you can fully rotate turret with this gun. So it's actually very, very nice thing. So if you want to go faster, you can do that. I'm joking, this is not double barrel gun, but still, it's cool. You can fully rotate turret and it's very, very nice. Now, speaking about the DPM, 6.1 seconds reload is bloodyful. It's very, very good. Alpha damage 400, if you are loading the high explosives, your alpha damage becoming 515 and you can pretty much do 5000 DPM with this tank if you are shooting the tanks which do not have armor. Well, for example, in this battle, I believe frontally you can penetrate Progetto. Remel, Super Hellcat, LTG, plus on top of that you can actually flank the other tanks and you can penetrate them frontally too. So, well, not frontally, from the rear, but you get the point what I'm saying. And the mobility of this vehicle is actually decent. Now, let's see how we are going to make this cute little thing work. So the first things first, I want to take this position over there and I want to punish people which is crossing. He is crossing, I want to fully aim, and 400 in the face is not bad start for us. Obviously, now when we are thinking if we would have the other gun, we would penetrate him for more likely 700. But, you know, it's still not the thing, for which we could complain. Our defender is super aggressive right here. And now look, our thing is very, very simple. We can't make a hardcore pressure over there. At least I don't really think we can. You know what? How about if I would try to play over there? A bit hold down. Just a bit. Hi there. We managed to hit him for 400. Also, the gun handling, if I'm not mistaken, is also relatively good with this tank. Although, aim time is a bit, you know, tricky thing. Okay, let's see. Can you peek? Pretty please. Pretty please. Just be kind to me. Peek and I will hit you. Come on. Come on, buddy. You can peek. You can peek. Just do it. I see this this guy over there. Chooked another 400 in the face. Beautiful. Hmm. Okay. I must admit one thing. I have a feeling I was or I were that bad dancer which balls disturbed him to perform well with this vehicle. I think I changed my mind about this tank. I haven't played it for a very long time, and at least in the first battles right there, the gun is actually working very, very well, and I must admit, I kind of like this tank, fellas. I kind of like this tank. You see, that's why I am saying, when people is asking skill, from when you became perfect, from when you know everything, I don't know everything in the game, and I want to be bloody honest with you, I just don't, and I'm not afraid to say so. So for me, this tank currently is like a hidden gem, if I can say so. I am actually enjoying playing with this vehicle, at least for this YouTube video, I for sure had a blast playing with this tank. And this is not a joke, it is a reality, my lovely friends. It is reality. So what is happening here? Our team is getting closer for the enemies over there. So what I'm waiting, I am waiting until those guys will try to hit someone over there, right? Because now currently both of them are pre-aimed for me. So all I need to do, I need to wait. And here we go. Unfortunate, but that was my fault. Now this guy is peeking sideways and he should die in a second. It's okay. Could be way, way, way more terrible situation for us, right? I have another plan. What is another plan? I am going to approach them from this area over there. Hopefully it's going to work, right? So what we are doing, we are going like this. This 263 just shot. So what that basically means, we can make a bit of pressure like this. And the 110 is going to be the very first victim which we are going to kill. Whenever this 110 is going to die, then we can start shitting on the other guys over there. And did I notice that convoy over there? Absolutely yes. So this convoy shot me in the face, and now we are going to finish him off in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. He is dead because I have a DPM gun and he had alpha damage gun, which is completely fine by me. Now what we want to do, we want to eliminate this 110 from the game right into the shithole. He is eliminated, and now what we are thinking about playing against those guys over there. So we are going for a tracking shot right there. Too bad that was not an excellent aim from my side, so I cannot complain too much right there. And we are peeking sideways because I simply don't mind. And we wasted the repairs from the IS-3. Now I'm reloading faster than this IS-3 is, but unfortunately I'm tracked and my crew is looking like a pile of poop. Someone of those two just shot, but I am not entirely sure who. It doesn't matter, we are going in and we are trying to track this object. Object is getting tracked right here. This is exactly what we want, but what we don't want, we don't want to get focused by the clickers. So what we are going to do now, and what is the main plan for us? I already have a strategy in my head. So we are going to load the standard ammunition for this IS-3, and we are going for this 263 over there. This is the plan, this is the hope, this is what we are going to do. So IS-3 should be dead, and then we are going to bang this 263 in the ass with the high explosives. Let's do this. I hope the IS-3 is not going to react properly right there. So let's go just like this, and IS-3 should be... Shame. Good. High explosive in the butt. Pay attention, 500 alpha damage. Shnai in the butt. 450, which is low roll, but it doesn't matter. It worked relatively fine, although, you know, I was kind of unlucky right there. I must admit that, but it's okay. I mean, aim was not excellent too, because I was kind of aiming for a cheek of the... of the IS-3 and knowing IS-3, knowing Ruski tanks, you know. Sometimes the tanks is not working that easily. Anyways, there is a Shtuneremel which is down to one shotable, and there is a Jagdtiger which is somewhere in the middle. So what do we want to do? We are thinking actually about Jagdtiger idea. How we can deal with this guy? How about if we are going like this through the field, and we will try to spot this guy somewhere around the middle? If that would be the case, maybe we would spot him going piri piri up here somewhere. Then there is a big chance we could actually even load high explosives and we could deal with this guy, right? Okay, how about this? Trying to go sideways like this and trying to spot him. Obviously can't see anything, which is very, very sad part of all this, but anyways. And now I decide to go and make a hardcore pressure just like this. Maybe this Jagdtiger came back for a base def, although I really doubt it. And he's over there. He did not spot us, which is just excellent. And now I want to see him going either down or either going a bit more up. He's going a bit more up. We have open shot. We are hitting him in the side. He's crying. He's definitely not smiling. We are using those double bushes as a bushes. And he is dead. Very good performance. I am happy with this tank, fellas. Looks like the grind in order to get up to 100% with a trash burn just became way better for me, since I am kind of enjoying this tank. So once again, my advice is about this vehicle. What kind of gun do I recommend to use? It is completely up to you, boys and girls. Absolutely up to you. Aiming, Russia. Ну пиздец. Okay, grinding of this tank just became way easier in my head. This is like a hidden gem for me, fellas. This is like a hidden gem. After those three battles, I think we played relatively well, and I must admit I'm enjoying this tank. Holy moly, guacamole, fellas. Beautiful. I never ever thought I'm going to say that, but I like Convoy. You are living and you are learning, right? So after three battles with a Convoy, we managed to get 4,000 average damage, which is humongous score for me with this vehicle. When I was marking it, my average is 2.7 plus 500. Holy bananas. Here you go. YouTube is good not only for you, but for me too. Because from the YouTube, my lovely friends, I am looking into those old tanks with which I haven't played in a long time. And I can have and research those hidden gems once again. Very, very nice performance. So, fellas, it was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one. And yeah, fellas, my knowledge just increased by the tiny bit. So it was useful not only for you, but for me too. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and skill is out.